Elea here. We're going to be doing the strength eye drape. And just to preface, this is the most difficult one. So if you start to feel a little discouraged, it's okay. Just send us a message or be part of that EBQ's Addicts Facebook group and post anything there. We're here to help you. And this is going to be a struggle for me too, even though I already know what my results are. But I'm going to try to do it like I don't for you guys. So you're going to have your strength eye drape, and you'll have the different colors, and make sure you lay them out in order. And then of course, remember, you're going to need like a piece of paper and then like the actual instructions. Okay, so let's go ahead, and I've already swatched up my arms, and I'll kind of walk you through how to tell if it's right for you. Hey, so remember that strength is your skin tone. So this is your most natural color, meaning that like for some of these, they might really blend into your skin, and that's normal. In fact, some of them are foundation colors, really just two of them. So if you are having trouble telling them, like if they're really close to your skin tone, take note of that, because it's something that you can use to know your value later on. Sometimes it's hard for us to know our value, you know, on a deep level, but also on a skin tone level. So just make it that note in your for your foundation orders and samples and stuff like that. Okay. So I'm gonna start with these light values. So they're the ones with the L after the number. And I'm just gonna kinda, and you, if you line them up as four, it's this row. So let's start with reasonable. And when I'm looking at this on my skin, it looks a little more yellow than in this packet, but it looks really close. So I'm gonna kind of take note of that, even though I don't particularly love that color. But remember, right now we're just kind of looking for what's the closest match. Like right here, this looks way more orange on my arm than it does in the packet, even though I really like this color. But so I'm thinking that I'm probably somewhere in between here just by judging these, and I'm gonna do a little paper test just to get a better look. So here's a Nate, and wow, this looks so much purple, more purple on my arm than it does in the packet. Like I know for sure this is not my color, like not even close to what it looks like there. And then this is impressive. Impressive looks pretty close on my arm. It's kind of like fading in really well, but it also looks a little more pinky and red. I might test that one too, just because this is my skin tone value, and actually this is a foundation color. So it's gonna be a little bit more difficult to see the differences maybe here than it will in other different values. Okay, so I'm gonna go to the next one. And these are like medium, so they have an M by them. And I'm gonna start with this instinctive color, which is a big color. And this looks a little bit more orangey, I guess. I mean, it looks really close. It looks slightly more orangey than green. Like this one has a little bit more green in it, I think, if you can tell. And then on my arm, it looks a little bit more yellow or orange, specifically orange. This is so far off. This is really far off. This looks way more red. So kind of what I was seeing over there, I'm seeing especially here. Even though I really like that color too, but it changes a lot on me. Now that doesn't necessarily mean it's not my best color, but just something to note. And here, this looks pretty similar, honestly, but I really don't like what it's doing on my arm, which makes sense because this one changed a lot. So those are the two things we're looking at. Like, how does it look on your arm, and how does it look, how true it is. This one does look more orange though, which is interesting because this one looked more purple, even though this is in the same group. Okay, And then this one looks pretty different too. It's a little deeper in the packet and it looks really red on my arm. Actually, it looks more orange than red on my arm. I think that's the difference. This has more of like that nice kind of coppery look to it in the packet, and on my arm it looks pretty red. And again, if you see how in the center area, I'm gonna kind of rub this down a little just to show you this, not just application. In the center area, it looks like kind of bruisey. And actually, if you look over here, that's happening there as well. I'm gonna spread this one out. This has a slightly similar effect, but I know that light colors aren't really my best, so that's something to keep in mind too. So I've kind of done these, and from my prognosis so far, in terms of how it looks on my skin, how true, this is the most true and this is the most true. This looks not bad on my skin. This looks really bad on my skin. And this also has like a really jarring, like it's a little too jarring difference there. On the light ones, this isn't very jarring, but, and it doesn't really do anything to my skin, but also kind of gives me a splotchy look. So I don't really like that. This is super different and very jarring. This one is not so bad, but it kind of gives me a jaundice-y look. And this is probably the best looking on my skin, so I know that since these are the most true and they look the best on my skin, these are probably going to be my zone, but I'll do a little test too. Okay, so for now, for the deeper values. And this is more my forte. Can you get that? Okay. So, I'm gonna start with this helpful color. And it looks way more green on here than it does on me. It looks pretty orangey and red, which is crazy. I mean, look at that difference there. So that's something to note. But then like, let's see, look at valuable. Look how different that looks on me. It looks so orange on my skin. Kind of gives me that little bruisey, sickly look too. Just like this one, which is the worst. That looks so sickly on my skin. It's such a pretty color, but it's not doing anything for me. So I kind of blending it down, because actually I should do that to both of these. I might have applied them a little heavy. But yeah, so this is way more orange on my skin than it is here. It's like a pretty coppery color here, and on my skin, it's so orange. Okay. And then Shameless. Shameless has changed a lot too. Again, it looks pretty orangey. Seems like I turn everything orange, I guess. And it doesn't look anything like the packet. So even though this one looked different, it's actually the most true one. And actually when I'm looking at it, it's also the one that looks like the best on my skin, which is wild because I don't really like that color very much. But anyway, all right, let's go here. So this is really true. Actually, this is probably the most true color that I've seen on my skin, which I know I look best in the deepest, so that kind of makes sense. And then here, yeah, this looks pretty brown on my skin and orangey again. Like, look how different that is from the packet. Almost looks like that's it, but I know it's not because I put them in the correct order because I was good. All right, and then let's go down here. That looks pretty close, actually. Looks pretty close. This does look a little bit more orangey and yellow, but it looks pretty close to the color in the packet. And like I said, I know I look best in those deep colors, so I'm just gonna keep that in mind. And then here, this one's really deep, and that one looks pretty close too. Let me kind of smear it out. The other one looks really close. It looks a little bit more orange and yellow, but not like crazy different. So that's kind of interesting. So for me, the most true ones on this arm are kind of different than the ones on this arm, except for this zone, which is, this one was the most true. It also looks really good on my skin compared to these two, for sure. Especially that one. That one's the absolute worst on me. I can't say that I hate these two, but I don't know if I also just don't like that color in general. Which is, this is the biggest thing with the skin tone zone, is that it's kind of hard to get over your bias, and that's why it's one of the hardest too. This one's kind of fade, so I know I'm in the extra light zone. And the deep colors, pretty much everyone except for this one looked really close on my skin. When I'm looking at these though, I hate this. It makes my skin look really sickly. This one's not so bad, which is interesting because I think overall, like when it came to my options, well, except for on this arm, that was kind of the one that I'm like, oh wait, no. Yeah, that one. Yeah, see that one, I still don't hate it. And I don't hate that, even though I hate that the most because it has that splotchy, bruisey look. So I'm gonna just kind of need to test some of them. And so I'm gonna go ahead and test these because I kind of already did that, just to kind of show the difference. Because if you look at this, especially probably on camera, it looks really close to my skin tone. So I kind of did this and you can really see the difference here. So this one right here, it looks pretty much spot on. Like it might look a little bit more brown, especially over there when I didn't like splotch it on, but it really is close. This one looks so different. It's so red on my skin and orange. And because I know how that works, I know that really if this is orange on me, then the only place I can really go is here. Because this looks really red and that looks purple. That means I need more yellow. So kind of seems like I'm gonna be in this most yellow zone, especially if in the lights, which are not my best, that's the one that looks the best on me. I'm gonna do one more test though. Okay, so I'm roping in a friend. I'm phoning a friend for this. And I have this on Gabrielle here. Here, move yours. No. That way. And we're gonna look at how they compare on there because we already know where Gabby lives on that. And really,
oh, you want to talk about a bruise, guys?
Yeah, that one. So this
on her. If I need costume
her,
makeup, then I'm good.
Yeah, that on her looks really bruisey. So look at the skin around it first of all, and see how like with me, it's kind of like more harmonious. Weirdly, even though it's so yellow, on her it's like. It looks like a bruise. Anyway, for this one on me, you need to blend that down a little bit more. But this one on me, it's not terrible, but like we saw on there, it changed a lot. Around my skin, it doesn't look super bad. But like, again, on her, especially look at that. It's just like, it looks like a bruise. It's really stark and it's kind of like, I'd say gross looking. And I can say that because it looks okay on me. Okay, so for this one though, when we look at around her skin, it looks way more harmonious on her than it does on me. And because now we're getting to where this looks bruisey on me, so it's not just her. And then this one too, it's got the same thing going on, where it's like, while this one I don't hate it on me, when I look at my skin, it's really stark difference. On her, it looks a lot more natural, even though it's not her best. This, we're both like ultra deep girls, so this is not gonna be our best zone, but it's not terrible. So I actually have shoes with this color and it looks really nice.
So now let's look at that one. You need to blend that one down a little more. So these are our best zones, and this is where things start to get more difficult to see. So on this, this looks really nice on me. This is actually probably my favorite color on there because it's nice and deep. That on her, again, bruisey. On this one on me, doesn't look too bad. It's not my favorite because it doesn't look like it's got any color at all, whereas this still has some color. This one, again, it looks kind of bruisey on her. And actually, see how that looks kind of green on her and it doesn't look that way on me? Green and yellow. And then this one, it has that really stark kind of like meh look. On her, it looks really nice and like, it has more color and it looks really like in harmony with her skin tone. And since this one is both really deep on both of us, actually I think on here this is the most obvious one. Like you can really see on her where this still has some color, it still looks like a brown, whereas on me it looks like gray and dark. So do this with a friend too, because it's really interesting, unless you guys happen to be the exact same one, to see how all the different colors play on you.
Okay, so now that I kind of have a result here, and if you could see how hard that was for me, like, just know this is the hardest. So definitely send us your notes and any photos if you have problems, and we'll help walk you through it. So for me, I figured out that really my best zone is in this S417 zone. But also in that 412 zone, there was some that looked, especially in the deeper, not so bad on me. So I'm gonna take that as a note. In the S417 zone, there was some that looked a little too yellow on me. So when I'm taking that note, it's important because when you do your swatches, you can kind of think about that. And also sometimes there are like in between zones. So for example, S415, that's in between 412 and 417. Sometimes they're intuitively numbered that way and sometimes they aren't. So just make sure that you say in your notes, like you saw these observations. So like for me in this deep color, I really like, that's a perfect shoe color. So that would be a great like shopping color for me. And one of my favorite eyeshadows, Treasured, it looks pretty similar to this, but it is a 417. And that is really natural on me, and that's also how I know that's my code too. So this right here, that's pretty much Treasured on the dot. And I love this color. Is it something I'm gonna like wear all over? If I wanna like look naked, maybe, but not really. So I do have a dress in this color actually, but it's got big flowers on it, so it looks less naked. But yeah, so a lot of these I really enjoy. So whereas like you can see how this, is that in this? Is very similar to that. I don't love this, but I do actually like this, which doesn't make any sense. Even though I know dark colors look best on me, I think it's still important to have a vibrant color, unless they're just like absolutely terrible on you, which I don't think is true for me. And so like a lot of these deep ones, I really love this, for example, and then that, and in this 415, we got something like this. So it's like, there's a lot of different options in those zones. So if you hate a lot of your colors that you've got, like don't panic, there's so many other colors in there. And then when you start ordering swatches, you're gonna get this little booklet. It's super helpful. It tells you like different, the color wheel and what the codes mean deep down. And then like how to like the color psychology. So if you're like, I really wanna make a big impression in this meeting and I want everyone to fear me, then you'll wear red. And then it also does like color relationships, which I did a few Facebook Live events with, and might get back to doing that. And that's really helpful to use. But you're also gonna just write your little swatches here so you can keep track of them. You're not ordering multiples. And you'll also keep track of your like results that you kind of wrote little notes about in here.
So again, if you have any questions, hit us up, we'll help you out. I'm a strength 417. My name's Elea.